the top public school in the world might be funding the next pandemic. Factory farming is brewing diseases like COVID-19, and as a chronically ill and disabled person, that puts my life in danger. So when I was accepted to UC Berkeley in the midst of a pandemic, I decided to conduct an investigation into the school supply chain to see what farms were supplying to my dining hall. Welcome to Seaboard Foods, a massive corporation that receives funding from UC Berkeley. With a group of fellow UC Berkeley students, I went inside to investigate animal cruelty and to test for what diseases might be brewing. The animals were really sick. We walked into one of the barns and practically every single pig was coughing and sneezing. We found documentation that they were administering at least 6 different types of antibiotics, as well as a plethora of other drugs. This creates ideal circumstances for antibiotic-resistant bacteria to grow. We collected fecal samples to try to confirm what diseases the farm was attempting to treat. According to UC Berkeley, this facility is humane. It is sustainable. It is ethical. But if those things were true, I wouldn't have to preface the rest of this video with a warning. Some of the footage you are about to see may be graphic, and viewer discretion is advised. The tests came back confirming an infectious virus was present on the farm called porcine circovirus. Porcine circovirus can cause those infected to waste away, and it can also cause stillbirths and miscarriages. We found thousands of pregnant pigs crammed into gestation crates. Crates so small that they could not turn around. California voters have rejected gestation crates, so UC Berkeley has turned to out-of-state factory farms to continue the cruelty. Because of the porcine circovirus, some of the mother pigs we found were giving birth prematurely. Their newborn babies were falling onto a hard floor covered in feces, blood, and urine. And with nowhere else to go, the newborn piglets were being crushed beneath the weight of their 800-pound mothers. They were falling into the cracks of the floorboards. They were starving to death, unable to access their mother's nipples.
We just found this little baby almost dead between her mom and the bars.
We had entered with the only intention of documenting, but listening to the piglets scream as their fragile bones were crushed was too much. We began to help them, to pull them out. But I knew that wouldn't save them in the end. If they weren't dead by morning, the farmers would come in and kill them. And I knew the mother pigs weren't safe either. Many of them were sick, many of them were covered in cuts, and many of them had vaginal prolapses, which is when their reproductive organs start to come out of their bodies. I knew that any mother pigs who weren't doing well would be gassed and then shot in the head. Their bodies would end up in this dumpster, like thousands of others. It's time that we fight back against this violent and destructive system. UC Berkeley is supposed to be preparing us to seize our future and create a better world. But instead, they are funding the very industry, destroying any chance we have. Nobody is protecting our future. It's up to us. That's why I am putting my life, my freedom, and my future on the line to end animal torture and expose future pandemics. Because if this pandemic doesn't kill me, the next one just might. Until we abolish animal agriculture, I won't be safe. None of us will be. Especially the animals.